All right, so this is a recording that I'm getting a bit emotional about, but this is a very tragic story. But this is talks about this accountant named Stephen McPherson, who over the weekend, this past weekend, he died saving his daughter from a bunch of would-be kidnappers in Boak Heights and community in outskirts of Montego Bay. And let's go and read the story. So the Boak Heights community on the outskirts of Montego Bay, St. James, was plunged into mourning this past Wednesday afternoon. Sorry, I thought it was a weekend, but it's this past week, last week, when a popular accountant was shot and killed by armed men who made a valiant attempt to stop them from abducting his daughter. The dead man has been identified as 57-year-old Stephen McPherson of the upscale Boak Heights community, which offers an elevated view of the western city. According to reports, after 4:30 p.m., the McPherson's 23-year-old daughter—they're not naming her for protection, obviously—exited the taxi community, was walking home when a bag of waste men, I'm paraphrasing, traveling a boxy bus and towed to motor car, basically started to wolf whistle her, and she basically ignored them. All right, no, she just probably thought that, okay, these are some idiots trying to. Thirsty idiots who are just trying to say some dumb shit to get attention, so I was gonna ignore him. But it took a more sinister turn when she was approaching a house. Men used both vehicles to block her path. They lighted from the vehicles with guns and demanded that she enter one of the vehicles or she be killed. I know what that would have led to, because what they meant was going to happen is that they weren't just going to just. It wasn't just a talk when it came to their sexual advance towards her, that they were planning on having their way with her by force. So, however, she was as okay. So here's go. So now, her father has approached home. The accountant realized daughter's been harassed and was crying. He drove vehicle towards the main apartment to rescue his daughter. Before he was able to exit the vehicle, one of these dirtbag scum suckers shot him. All right, McPherson lost control of the vehicle, which crashed with a neighbor's fence. During the commotion, daughter managed to escape while attackers jumped back into the vehicle and sped away. And so after he, when the police arrived, they found McPherson crashed a motor car, multiple gunshot wounds. So that means that as they're leaving, they shot him several times just because he had the gall to prevent him from harming his daughter. And you know what happened after that. All right. And so this is pretty much this is it. No, it says that, and it says that McPherson was the last. The three person was shot and killed by a gunman in St. James between this last week. Identified male shot and killed along Love Lane, downtown Mobe, shortly after Boak Heights shooting. While 37-year-old Jermaine Samuels, Mason Littlepot, was shot and killed in the Contact community near Adelphi this last week. Damn. All right, so, and I said, the latest murders bring to the number of persons killed in St. James start of the year over the comparative period last year. 72 persons were killed. Yeah, the bloodshed and carnage continues. So that's the end of the article. So when I read the story last night, yes, I was filled with rage though, because what galls me is that you had a brave nobleman who went out like a hero protecting his daughters from some pieces of shit right there who tried to harm him. And yet, and the thing to note is that I know a lot of Jamaican men, well, a lot of black men around the globe get this bad rap of being these shitty parents. We don't care about our women. That were brutes and cowards. And when you hear that, when you have stories like this that defy that narrative, it's not going to get as much attention. Because the thing is, what kills me is that this guy, that in a country where you have pieces of bottom feeders like those scumbags who try to adopt his daughter. You have right. You have these brave noblemen like Mr. McPherson, and yeah, I did not know him before he's in passing, so I can't fully see what kind of person he was. But he went out like a true warrior, and I've always said in my recordings when it comes to all the bullshit that goes on here in Jamaica that you need a warrior class, you need a group of men who are about that life, who want to protect their families and other innocent people from the criminal elements that are ravaging this country. And this is what I have to salute about this brave man. This guy was a warrior. All right. Yeah, I didn't know him in real life. Can't say what he was, whatever, but from what the fact that this guy was willing to put his life on the line to make sure his daughter's okay. And there's this guy, and he noticed that this guy didn't have a firearm, but he said, you know what? He said that, okay, if I could, he could have been like one of these many cowards who could have just saw empty his daughter, just pussied out somewhere, just tucked his tail and ran. And then after they went, he would they left. He could have called the police. And I'm sure the police wouldn't have done shit anyways. And let's be honest right there. But this guy said, you know what? If I have to, if this is my last act on earth, I want to make sure my daughter's safe. Because what this guy did, he prevented another Jasmine Dean. All right? Because this girl, his daughter could have been another Jasmine Dean right on the spot. Where if they had gotten away with her and did what they want, they had their wicked way with her, he chances are would never seen her alive again. And as and if they all right, and if he's looking to find her body, that's if he's looking to, if they left her alive though. The chances that of her him ever seeing her again would have been zero to none. But this guy said, "No, you're not going to do it to my daughter. And if it's my time to go this moment, I'll gladly do it, saving my own flesh and blood." And what kills me is that, yeah, you have people in the comment section that bring up this brave man. What you're not seeing in the public eye is that you're not seeing all these human rights groups. You're not seeing all those Black Lives Matter protests. You're not going to see all those people who pretend that they cared about Jasmine Dean and those bitch asses punked out when they had a live protest. You're not going to see a lot of those people acknowledging Stephen McPherson. All right, that's what I'm likely thinking. I'd like to be wrong. Chances are I won't be. But all I can say is that this guy's, I'm just glad that his daughter's safe and alive, that she didn't end up like one of those many missing people that you all see end up in the papers that are never found again after some criminal jackals take them away, have their wicked way with them, and then dispose of the body. And if you, and that's if you're lucky enough to find what the body is. Because I said that she could have easily been another Jasmine Dean on the spot. But at the same time, she just lost a man who helped bring her into this world. So she's in a state of mourning right now because she had a near-death experience and her and she lost her father who gave his life to protect hers. And so we have to pray for this woman though. Because the fact that she most likely seen their faces, she has to be under protection. With the hopes that they find these cowardly jackals who did this to her father. And all I can say is that when I read stories like this, I just said something on Politics Watch because he just broke this down on his YouTube page just now, and I'm in complete agreement with him though, is that I'm complete agreement with what I said. But what I said on his on his video on this story, he said people like this make me regret that Denzel Washington's character from The Equalizer isn't a real person. Like if you know his character Robert McCall in the Equalizer films, there's a guy that basically fends those who are victimized by criminal scum. And this guy doesn't do the thing where he takes you in. Well, if you're lucky, he'll take you in alive, so if he's justice. This guy does what Frank Castle, aka the Punisher, does. Like he sends you off the mortal coil in a very brutal, violent way. And bear in mind, the people he does that to deserve it fully if you watch the films. We need. I just regret Pete, there aren't, isn't a Robert McCall in Jamaica who's really about that life, who would have hunted these dirtbags down and sent these guys off the mortal coil in the most violent way. Let them know what it feels like to be go like a victim, go like a victim, and to meet upon someone who's way more terrifying and more badder than you. Because these guys are cowards, all right? Like you could, like I said, like you could have only taken this woman. In, if you had their numbers and your weapons, like one and on, you're not going to do it, especially not with a dad. Like not those quarter, three quarters of a man would have ch dared challenge her father on one and one without a weapon. And this just shows me that they get to live at least for now. This guy dies, and this is one of the where it should have been reversed. Like a man like this deserves to live a full life. Being a paragon of virtue in Jamaica, while those criminal scums need to end up like a pricky boy and be let them be reunited with their masters in hell. That's all I can say though. But this is just what like I said. I was going to get emotional with this, but I didn't know this guy. But this guy was a went out like a warrior, and we have to commend this guy and the people in Mobe. I know not all of you are spineless cowards. I know there's some people that life, all of you should be working on two things. One, well, three things. One, consoling and protecting this daughter, all right? Because I know those cowardly jackals are going to try and come for her because she's probably seen their faces. I might know to identify them. Or they just want to clean up all loose ends. All right, you need to protect and console this daughter, all right? Because this poor woman is grieving right now. She has lost a man who was there for her, who gave his life to protect her. Number two, after you bury this guy, make sure that people know who Stephen McPherson is. Those who know him life, let's honor these people. Because you're not going to trust the public media to do it, because that doesn't fit their narrative. Having a Jamaican who's a virtuous person who's not a coward, yeah, that doesn't suit their narrative. Because end of the day, again, those human rights groups, I'm certain I have to beat upon y'all. Those people are protesting with George Floyd at the embassy. None of these hypocrites are going to be out in full force just protesting Stephen McPher for Stephen McPherson. You're not going to be seen, likely going to be seen the media acknowledge this guy the way they should, because the narrative, like, oh, Jamaican men, black men especially, are a bunch of worthless do-nothing men. That goes against that narrative, all right? Because they're not going to, a lot of those people aren't going to acknowledge people like this, that they're warriors like this man went out when everybody in this should be making the front headlines. And tell the fact that it didn't really, it has gotten as much attention it needs to get, that's very telling of the psyche of this country. And shame on all y'all. And the most important thing is, find these guys. Some people know who these guys are. Find them, or like do what like what Barney Ross in Expendables 2 said: track them, find them, kill them. All right, and I mean that. All right, after you bury this man, Steve McPherson, work on burying his killers next. Though that these are people that are not fit to live on the soil. All right, so that is the most important thing you're gonna work on. That you're going to be putting them with Pretty Boy and all these other criminal sewer rats who are not fit to live on the planet. And that's all I want to say. And this is for Steve McPherson. You went out like a warrior. And also, we need a warrior class. This guy showed he's part of that warrior class. And we need to hear more so about Steve McPherson's. We need more men like that in Jamaica and the rest of the diaspora. All right. So this is for State of Jamaica and the Caribbean. Check out my YouTube pages, Miles Goodson Ferrin, Miles Productions, and Real Thoughts of Miles. Okay.